What's going on, guys? Welcome back. In a previous video, I showed you how to query JSON data that's stored in S3 from AWS Athena. And in today's video, I want to show you how to query that data from a Lambda function. So this is the general setup of how we're going to do this. So we're going to create a Lambda function and we're going to submit that to Athena. And then once Athena gets around to processing that query, it's going to deliver it to S3. Now, keep in mind here, there is a slight nuance into how querying Athena works. It isn't a standard query in terms of how you would query maybe a Dynamo database where you get an immediate response. When you query Athena, it's on a best effort basis. So Athena tries to perform your query as quick as it can, but it can't guarantee any form of service level agreement. So in some cases, you may get a query that responds in just a few seconds. In other cases, it can take several minutes. So just keep that in mind. Now, for that reason, it also means that a Lambda probably isn't the best tool to both submit the query and read the result, since the amount of time Athena will take to process the message is undeterministic. So you don't know how long your Lambda should sleep if it wants to analyze the result. Now, if you want to analyze the result, the best way to probably do that is to have a Lambda that submits the query, and then when Athena delivers the output to S3 as a JSON object, set up a JSON trigger on that S3 delivery or put event to trigger a different Lambda to go and download that S3 content and parse it out. But in this exercise, I'll show you how to submit the query and do a slight little hacky kind of thing where we can actually query back Athena and look at the results. Okay, so that's what we're gonna do. So let's head over to our database over here. So I have a default database as part of my previous video where I created this. I'll link that in the description section below. Also have a table here, and I just ran a very basic query, select star from my table and limit that to 10. We can see here that we have 10 or so results. And so we have an ID, our type is a refund, our amount is a double, and the date. Now we're gonna query this database from Lambda. So let's go and set that up now. Gonna go to Lambda. Gonna click on create function. Gonna be using Python for this. Let's just call this Athena demo. And we're gonna use Python 3.8. And we do need a specific IAM role. I already created one. It's called, in my case, the Lambda Athena role. Now the role that you create needs a couple different permissions. It needs the Athena start query execution, Athena get query execution, Athena get query results, and glue get table. I'm going to provide a link to that in the source code so that you don't have to memorize that. Okay, so we have this role set up with those permissions. Let's go ahead and click on create function, and the function got successfully created. Okay, so down here is our source. I want to make one small adjustment before we do anything else, and that's to adjust my timeout. I believe that's over here. Yep, basic settings, timeouts here. Because I'm going to be doing a little bit of a thread.sleep, I need to adjust this so I can, it will be longer than 3 seconds. So let's just say 5 minutes. The number is a little bit high, but better safe than sorry. Okay, so here's the code. So let's actually jump into Sublime now, and I'm gonna actually write it in here. Okay, so let me expand this, make it a little easier. So here are the permissions that I mentioned, the start query execution, get query results, and get table. Okay, so the first thing we wanna do is set up our query in client. So we're gonna say client is equal to 3.client, and we're gonna use the Athena client. And also keep in mind, I have these imports up here, JSON, Boto3, and time. So now we want to actually set up and perform the query. And perform query. Okay, so we're going to say query starts, and we're going to say client.start query execution. And this takes a couple parameters here. So the first one is query string. And that's just going to be your basic SQL query. Mine was just what we had before, select star from AWS simplified Athena demo, and we'll just limit that to 10 so we don't blow this thing up. And the second thing, comma, we need our query execution context, and this is where we specify the name of our database. We have to provide it with a string or a key database. And the value being, in my case, I'm using the default database, but if you have a specific database that you created for your Athena setup, you want to specify the name here. And the third thing is results configuration. And this is where your result is going to be delivered. So it needs to be an S3 bucket. So I already have one pre-created. I'll type it in here. It's called S3 AWS simplified results slash. So that's the name of my bucket. You need to create your own. This is a required parameter. So if you don't provide this, it's going to blow up. So make sure you just go and create a dummy bucket so that you can deliver the results to. So that's all we need to do to actually perform the query. Now we want to actually take a look at the results, right? So observe results. So we're going to extract the query ID from the query start, from this object. We're going to extract the query ID from it because we need that to call an Athena API. So we're going to say query execution ID. We want to extract that from query start. And now we want to make an actual call to Athena to get the query results. But before we do that, remember, we need to sleep now. So back to the diagram I had over here, we're submitting the query to a queue. We don't know if this is going to take 1 second, less than 1 second, 5 seconds, 15 seconds, who knows? Can take even longer in some cases. But we need to sleep here so that Athena has time to process the results. Now, if you try to query this too quickly, you're going to get a response that just has a queued message. It's not going to actually be the query content that you submitted. So like I was saying before, if you want to do this correctly, probably have an S3 trigger set up on the put, but just for demonstrations, I'm going to show you how to read the results too. Okay, so back to this. And so now we actually need to sleep for a little bit. So I'm just going to say this for, time.sleep, right? Time.sleep, yeah, 15, we'll say 15 seconds. I'm not sure if this is going to work. We'll try a couple numbers. If this works, great. If it doesn't, we'll increase that up a little bit. Now we want to actually perform the query. So results is equal to client get query results. And we need to pass in the query execution ID. That was what we were getting from up here, query execution ID. We want to say that is equal to query ID because that's what we assigned it to. And now we just want to iterate over the results. So there's a special kind of dictionary response that comes back in this results object. I'll spare you the details, but you just want to say for row and results, and then we want results set, and we want rows. And we'll just say print row. Oops, I missed a colon up there. That's not a colon. That's a colon. Print row. Okay, so that's looking pretty good. Let's just take a quick look at what we did here. Set up the client. We're performing some basic query, providing with a default database, an output location. And now we want to actually take a look at the results. We need to sleep because the time it's going to process is non-deterministic. And then we get the query results, and now we're printing out the output. So let's just take that, head over to Lambda, click on save. Okay, I need a test event. We're not reading off the input, so this doesn't matter, foobar or whatever you want. Now let's click on test, give this a minute. So it's gonna be 15 seconds because I submitted the sleeper 15 seconds, so it'll be at minimum that amount of time, plus the invocation duration, however it may be. So this should be over in a second or so, assuming I didn't screw anything up. And execution failed. Query ID is not defined. What did I do? Query ID. There you go. Query ID. All right, so let's give that another shot. All right, so there are our results. So we have the data row, and we have the first column, or the first row is actually the column name. So the ID, the type, the amount, and the date, those were our columns. Then here's all the data that got delivered. So the first one's the ID, second one is the refund or purchase, third one's the amount, and the last one is the date. So if you like this video, I have many more on S3 and Athena, so be sure to check out my channel. Also, please don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss out on next week's video. Thanks so much, folks, and I'll see you next time.